The film Trapped Cinderella is a story of about two girls that have grown up together until they were aged about 10, and they had a really intense relationship as kids together, and then they get separated and then they bump into each other in London, and it's just trying to find that relationship again. And it explores, it's a dark story, and it explores the thin line between friendship and obsession.
And your character, you play a girl called Do. Yeah. Tell me a bit about that.
She is a fragile thing, and she has an intense relationship with Tuppence's character, Mickey. And she has a lot of jealousy towards Tuppence's character, and stuff that she wants to have within her own character that she doesn't have, she doesn't possess. So she clings on to that, and it can end quite, well, it's quite a sad story for her, yeah.
And what was it that attracted you to this film? Because it's a very dark and emotional story.
Yeah, it was that really, that it was so dark and emotional. I hadn't played a part that was so fragile before. I'd just come off The Iron Lady, so Margaret Thatcher and Do, completely different. So I love a challenge, so I embraced that really.
I was going to say, was it one of the biggest challenges for your career so far?
You know, all jobs have different challenges, and this one did sort of, you know, make me flex my acting muscles per se, and yeah, that's what I get my kicks out of.
And one of the interesting things about this film is it really explores a lot of different emotions. So how did you work with the director to make sure that you got this right?
Yes. Well, it was essentially Ian Softley who wrote the film and directed it. It's his baby, because he's been thinking about it for a long time. So, you know, you come on later on into the project where they've been thinking about it for years, and you kind of have to do your own thing with it, and Ian did let me do that, and I hope I made him happy.
I'm sure you did. And I believe you filmed in the south of France and in Britain, so tell me a bit about that. What was the highlight of the whole production for you?
Obviously, filming in the south of France,
sunbathing there,
was a massive highlight. We didn't have much time off, but it was gorgeous. Yeah, my family came out with me, and yeah, it was just lovely. And this, when you're away, that's when the crew and everyone really bond together. And me and Tuppence, we're very close now. It's just lovely.
And could you tell me a bit about the chemistry when you were working on set with Tuppence? How did you two interact, and, you know, make sure that on screen you had this such an intense chemistry, yeah, that you got that so perfect?
We did a lot of chemistry building, character building things together, because of we had a challenge. We had to get our body shapes to look quite similar. Me and Tuppence are completely different body shapes. So we did a lot before going out to France. We did a lot of Bikram yoga together, which is a bonding thing, if you call, because it's 90 minutes. It's a long class, and we did it every day for, I'd say, like 20 days, in order to change our bodies. And it helped me, because I became quite obsessive about, you know, changing my body shape in order to look like Tuppence's body. So it helped with the psychological development of the character.
Wow, well, thank you so much for that. And apart from this movie, what else have you got coming up for 2013?
This year I've got a film called One Chance coming out, where I play, it's a film about the story of Paul Potts, the guy that won Britain's Got Talent, the opera singer. So James Corden plays him, and I play his wife. And then I've got Cuban Fury as well, and Utopia. I've got a few things coming out, yeah.
And have you started filming the one with James Corden?
Yes.
And how's that going? How do you enjoy working with him?
Yeah, it was amazing. We had such a laugh doing it. Yes, it was just a laugh. I just couldn't believe I got paid to do it, to be fair.
Trapped for Cinderella is an Ian Softley film, which we made in France, which was rather lovely. And it's intriguing, and it's scary and violent, and it's about manipulation and control and tormenting someone else, and adoration and obsession.
Wow, that's a lot to get into one answer. And could you tell me a bit about your character as well in this movie?
My character is quite lowly, I suppose, and subservient, and full of resentment.
Was it a character you enjoyed playing particularly? If so, why?
Oh, I got to drive this fantastic convertible Mercedes. And film in the south of France. No, she's. It was funny when I watched some of it. I was really pleased with some of the scenes, with the sort of the wit of them and the complexity of the manipulation. I was pleased with it.
What is it that there's this chemistry between the two leading ladies? Is that, would you say, the part of the film that's going to attract all the viewers that makes it different?
Well, they're two pretty fantastic actresses, and they did play really well together. And I think they had fun doing it. And because you don't really know who's who, or the games that they're playing, or who's in control of who at any point, there is a magic to what they're doing.
And what was it about this script that attracted you?
I'd known Ian for some time and was thrilled to be asked to work with him because he's made some fantastic films. And also because, you know, the characters are not straightforward. I think the more you work, the easier it gets in a funny sort of way. Yeah, strangely, luckily. And in that situation, you know, I was able to recognise my own experience and how much film work I've done and what fun I can have. And it's sort of, I'm finding work much, much easier as I get older, yeah. And I only go to work to enjoy it.
So if work's getting easier, what else do we have that's coming up in 2013 or perhaps 14?
I've just finished an Irish film called Patrick's Day, which is, I play the mother of a schizophrenic boy who tries to eradicate a memory from her son's mind.
You continued the theme of memories and memory loss. Is that deliberate?
I think these things are all part of the zeitgeist, aren't they? They turn up at the same time. I've also just been working for Gay TV in Canada, which was pretty crazy and fun, on something called Sex and Violence.
Well, it's based on a French novel written in the 60s by quite a famous French writer, and it reminded me of a lot of Hitchcock films and New Wave films that I was interested in, and it really inspired me when I was younger, and I think the themes of obsession and identity at the centre of it really intrigued me, and that because we're introduced to characters and they're confused about who they are, because obviously the film begins with one of the lead actresses having an amnesia, so that it's a very good story to tell in the cinema, because you can deal with things in your, is it real, is it not real?
Yeah. And I do believe it was made into a film, a French film in 1965, so in comparison to that, what do we see in this one?
Well, nobody's seen that film. No, and I spoke to the writer when he was alive, and he said, well, don't bother looking at it. Hardly anybody saw it at the time, and he didn't think it was successful, even though I think he wrote the screenplay. So he said, just, you know, imagine that it's a new opportunity. Stanley Kubrick was going to make a film of this book at one stage. And, you know, he's a great sort of inspiration for me. So that kind of made me even more convinced that it was something that would work well as a film.
And it's got this fantastic retro feel. So how did you go about making sure that you got that charm into it that would come across to the audience?
Well, it came about sort of through a number of ways. I mean, I was obviously, I lived in France before I went to university. And at that time, I saw a lot of films. I was introduced to cinema. We made it for very little money, and I was intrigued by the way that those French New Wave films were made for very little money. And I think what evolved was an approach that was quite free and really putting people on the streets, on the beaches, in clubs, and allowing the scenes to evolve, mm-hmm. and there being an interaction between real people and the actors, which is exactly what they did in those New Wave films. And I think that has kind of created the look through the sort of practicality of it, you know.
And do you believe that it's that special chemistry between the two leading ladies that makes this film stand out from the rest?
Well, I hope, yeah, I hope that that's the thing that, you know, people relate to. It certainly, I think it's really strong element in the film. They're very different, but they, of course, you know, have similarities. One is obsessed with the other. but I think that there's an intensity about them both on screen. And it's exciting as well that they are relatively at the beginning of their careers, so that they're not overexposed. So the audience has the chance of kind of, you know, meeting people for the first time really on the screen.
And I mean, we just spoke to Alexandra and she said, oh, it's Ian's baby. So was it more challenging for you as a director to create a film that's quite close to your heart?
I don't think it was more challenging. I think it was, you know, the first film I made, Backbeat, was, I hadn't made any films before, but it felt like, in a way, I was on familiar territory. And I think I had a similar feeling here. And the fact that I adapted it meant that I was able to improvise a little bit as well, because I didn't have to check that I was, you know, offending the writer, because I was the writer. It always helps, yeah. So I think from that point of view, I was just really grateful that I got the chance to make it, and it felt a lot of the time kind of like a dream, you know, to be able to do that, because it was something that had been inside me for so long that it was, there seemed to be very little interruption or very little sort of obstruction between the film that I had in my head and the film that I tried to put out there.